Mission of Germany to the UN. Here, Mrs. Tanra Jeni, Deputy the Permanent Representative of the Mission of the Republic of Lithuania to the United Nations. Mr. Liberato Batista.
Can you hear?
Again, Dr. Michael Papanoschka of the Permanent Mission of Germany to the UN. Mrs. Kazra Jeni, Deputy Permanent Representative of the Permanent Mission of the Republic of Lithuania to the United Nations. Mr. Liberato Bautista, former President of Congo. Honorable panelists, esteemed guests of NGOs, civil society, private sector, dear friends. On behalf of the Baltic Sea Forum, I cordially welcome you to our side event. Green Rose for a Blue Sea, how to protect our oceans and create jobs. Innovations for clean oceans, using example of the strategic Interreg EU project Clean Baltic Sea Shipping. There are so many countries situated on ocean sites or linked to oceans by big rivers, so that the subject of national and international transport using those waters as important waterways needs good examples on how to protect the water and provide good infrastructure for the countries and their people. The Clean Baltic Sea Shipping, CBSS, is such a best practice, a success story. Mr. Bodewijk will give you an overview, Dr. Pushra a global sight, Mrs. Ritz and Mr. Warnschaft a perspective of UN point of view, and Mr. Björk the project. Now I give the floor to Mr. Kurt Bodewijk, former Federal Minister for Transportation, Infrastructure and Housing in Germany, Chairman of the Executive Board of the Baltic Sea Forum, Maritime Ambassador in Germany of the EU Commission.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, it's an honor for the Baltic Sea Forum that you will show this interest to the issues of our theme of this day, Green Growth for Blue Sea, how to protect our oceans while creating jobs. And that's the connecting links. We want to give some ideas to protect our environment and also give new chances for people, for professional work, for innovation, and for new steps to the future. And protection of the environment and employment are two essential factors for all people on Earth. Many efforts to protect the environment are automatically labeled as economic strains without the high cost of unintended environmental pollution being taken into account. Let us be clear about one thing. The most important element on our planet is water. Also, 90% of our planet's surface is covered by water. The vital role that the ocean plays in our survival has not yet been fully anchored in human consciousness. It is not yet clear to everyone what the melting of the ice on the Arctic and